has evolved from the traditional Bermuda kite and Somerset kite to a kite that was made from, that comes out of this area. We usually fly out of the dump, Bernard's Park, or behind us, Peaks Field, Frizzler's Hill, Happy Valley. All this area is known as the Porn Dog area. Guys come from around this way and known as Porn Dog Flyers. That's where the Super Kite originated from, but not the Lard Kites. The original Lard Kites come from Somerset. The Super Kites that we fly now come from the city. They're taking the Somerset Kite to the next level with advanced technology and battle materials. So I put up a kite, I just put the Hummer on. I hope the Hummer stays on. But yeah, I think my mate should be down there flying already.
Yeah. Alright, so what you got going on right now so far?
I got nothing. I'm gonna put up this kite right here. Make some noise. Trying to beat out your old man, you know what I mean?
Alright.
He's just a bad kite champ. Not speak in the kitchen unless you're spoken to. So all it was about looking and learning. You know what I mean? So from that day on, I was like, that's what I want to do. I want to make a kite. So at that time, like I had so many kites in the house, and I was a little boy, so my old mommy just fly them and fly them and fly them until I got bigger. Then I started making my own little kites, and you know what I mean? But all the kites were mine. Like whatever was made, that were mine. I flew them all. And I like passing the kites, never stopped.
I think there's a bit to do.
You fly from press.
One door.
How old were you when you first started flying kites?
Well, first started playing kites, I only say kites. The same pre-kite that I used to make for Clevante and Zayden was a chip bag. Or a bread bag. Tie two pieces of string, bring it to one single string, throw it up in the wind, and sail it. I had a talent for being able to get a bread bag to fly about 200 or 300 yards in the air. And I was only like 5 or 6 then. And that was the beginning of my kite escapades.
How do you define the difference between kite flying now versus kite flying then?
Well, kite flying then was, well, it depends on where you came from. In time, where we're from, back in time, like I said, kites were up a month before Easter. So, day and night, they were up, you heard them. And the week of Easter, hundreds, and Good Friday, thousands of kites from Somerset to St. George's. You know, and Somerset, that's a whole different, that's a kite fraternity up there that he, are the creators of the loud kites. Not a super kite, but loud kites. Singers, as they call them up Somerset. Or bombers, as we call them. Mm-hmm. As people from town used to call them. But the evolution of that kite to today's kite, that kite started out where today's kite is, the super kite.
And I know you mentioned the super kites. So explain to us what's the difference between a super kite and the traditional kites.
A super kite is a kite that has evolved from the Somerset kite, which was basically a brown paper kite, tall in length and stature, but it had a tissue paper hummer. Whereas a super kite, which has evolved from around these parts in the city, is built for high winds and all weather. Whereas tissue paper kites cannot stay up in rain. A super kite can stay up in high winds and high rain. If it's tailed right and it's got the right string and loop on it, it will stay up all night. It will stay up for 2-3 days, no matter how high the wind comes up. Now, I'm flew up into 30 to 50 knots. Mm-hmm. So a super kite is totally different. It's evolved from, shall we say, a tissue paper kite, which is tissue. It's porous. You can go through it. Sticks are thinner. So
Yeah, they're delicate.
Can you bring it over so we can see?
Sure. Now, super kite. This is a porn dog kite, as we call them. So they would have thicker sticks. The skin, or the covering, or the dress, as we call them, is something that's called ripstop. And ripstop is used to make umbrellas, tents, parachutes, water ski kites.
That thing looks stronger.
Yeah, it's much stronger. It's sewed together. It's not glued together. The glue that we keep it on is a very high-borne, high-strength super glue that keeps these kites together and to the stick. And regular glue that works with these kites wouldn't even work with these. But yeah, everything is different, from the strings that we fly it with, to the hummer line, to the sticks, the shape of the sticks, to the tail that's put on the kite. The tail on this kite would be twice as long as the tail on the bigger kite, because these kites are designed to actually turn in the air, which makes them make more sound. These kites are much louder than those kites. Those kites cannot achieve the sound of these, simply because this is built for sound. This is built for rain, it's built for wind, and it's built to smash and to crash in the ground and not get destroyed. That will get destroyed before you get it out of the car, if you're not careful on a windy day. But this is built for a windy day.
How has kite flying affected your family, if at all?
My family? It's always been a good thing in my family, because during Easter time they know I'm making kites, and it's a family participant thing. You know, I make the designs, I come up with the concepts. You know,
who picks the paper?
You pick out the colors, you color scheme the hers. So we work as a team. But even, you know, teaching the kids, remember they were young. I don't know about Clevante, but Zayden knows how to make kites, he's made kites. Cle's always been a runner. He'll run after the kite for us, I guess. And yeah, these are groups of guys that actually we collectively get together, and we try to preserve this tradition by not only just flying the kites, but during the festive times, Easter times, we go out of our way to make sure that we try to teach this art of Bermuda local kite making.
So you go out into the community as well.
So we go into the churches, we go into the schools. I've done a seminar with 120 different delegates from all over the world at Southampton Princess this year. We flew kites for them. Have many invitations to come and fly in their states where they were from. Me being part of many different kite organizations around the world and posting on Kite Warriors. We have a Facebook page, Kite Warriors. And when we post on their foreign pages, the interest is off the chart, because our kites make noise. And, you know, their kites are beautiful. They sit there on a nice, you know, pretty day, but our kites dance and they sing and they make noise. So the interest level is really...
Before you came round, my heart would never be much faster. Before you came round, I was ready to slow down. Before you